on the Weather Channel.
Cars were blown off the road. That's how powerful Super Typhoon Usagi was when it slammed into southern China as a typhoon yesterday. This vehicle was just one of several that was flipped over.
Yeah, the 175-mile-per-hour winds weren't the only problem. Check out the storm surge. Yeah, and because of this, the death toll across Asia is almost at 36.
And all the tropical action is on the other side of the world. But we want to check in now with storm tracker Jim Cantore.
Yeah, he is live in the Global Forecast Center with your tropical update. Jim, what are you watching?
Well, let's go back and look at Usagi because it's certainly worth looking at again. And thank goodness we haven't had anything like this affecting our coastline or really any coastline for that matter. This is probably the strongest typhoon of the season in any basin. Let's take a look at it here. You can see the eye and just the central dense overcast. Notice where the eye is with respect to that. So it's almost this perfect donut, all right? And then these beautiful, what we call lungs or outflow channels with this, which is where the storm breathes. So you got all this air coming in and then exiting the system in these outflow channels. So it is basically a perfect machine. When you look at the length of time this has been with us, when you look at the strength, the intensity of the storm, and you kind of maximize that in a formula we call ACE, we come up with a value of 23.5, all right? If you look at all the storms that we've had so far in the Atlantic Basin, we come up with 23. These are all of our storms in the Atlantic. So we have not even equaled the same energy that that one storm has put out so far this year. So it's an amazing storm indeed. Here it comes on shore, and typically, as is the case, when a storm comes on land, it loses that warm water as a fuel for that whole mechanism. And as you can see, it pretty much collapsed in through here. That's the good news. And now Hong Kong is dealing with clear skies, as is Taiwan. Again, remember, Taiwan had about 30 inches plus worth of rainfall out of this thing. Now, Usagi really strengthened. It became a super typhoon right in through here. It was weakening a little bit south of Taiwan and then weakening even further before it came about 50 miles or so to the northeast of downtown Hong Kong. And thank goodness it was to the northeast. So that means all the wave action was on the east side. Poor news for the folks on the north side of this thing, but still, Basco got 923 measured pressure there, 110 in terms of the gust. And because of the topography here, all right, there are the mountains, you just got absolutely slammed with the flow around this thing of moisture. So you squeezed out tremendous amounts of rain here on the windward side of this thing. All right, so the wrap up on Usagi, strongest storm of 2003 in any basin, more energy than all of our nine Atlantic storms, including one barely hurricane, and nearly 3 feet of water in Taiwan. Now, we have a storm system that's sitting around here in the western Gulf of Mexico, and typically this time of the year, if you've got an area of low pressure sitting here in the western Gulf of Mexico, holy smoke, we're in trouble. But not this time, because if you look at the atmosphere around this wave, which is basically on the tail end of a front at 1,004 millibars, look at the dry air. All of this orange is dry air, so that means this system will not develop, nor do we expect it to. So the tropics remain very, very quiet here in this late September. Alex and Mark, back to you.
Thank you so much, Jim. Well, two action-packed hours of the Weather Channel's newest hit show, Heavy Metal Monsters, is heading your way in just minutes.
And here is a sneak peek of why some loggers in tonight's all-new episode are looking towards the sky.
We are constantly watching for variations in the wind, so as we're not going to jeopardize safety of the crew underneath us.
The next challenge is delivering the 4 tons of cedar wood to the drop zone on the river.
We're heading to the drop zone. We're keeping everything in our flight path in focus, be it birds, be it air traffic.
The target area is packed with boats and barges, so precision flying is critical for the drop. Ward nails it time after time.
Well, back-to-back episodes, including an all-new episode at 9 p.m. Eastern, are headed your way next.
And then we are back for Weather Center Live at 10 Eastern, and we'll have live weather updates every 30 minutes right on through the night.
That's right. We want to leave you with a look at the nation's capital, Washington, D.C., looking beautiful on this Monday evening. And, Mark, the Northeast has been really nice with actual fall-like temperatures.
Yeah, that cold front is now well off the coast, allowing for some of that cool air from the north to spill on in. And not only D.C., but also up in Times Square, you might even need an extra layer on if you're walking the city tonight.